I'm immediately recording the second episode back to back, but have to break it up for the sake of YouTube being weird about upload times. So I have not taken a break in between episodes. But you will be taking a break from seeing episodes because of YouTube being the way it is. So slow. Hopefully my slow approach is interesting, because I am looking for details for Shadows of Rose and trying to find things that maybe have not really been noticed before. I already forgot to adjust the sensitivity setting, so if this becomes a problem, I will definitely do that. Okay, that I already had open. The way that we came in before is closed, so now we only have this hole in the wall to go by. It is now morning because I take that long to look at things. Nah, this is bad. I'm going to fix the mouse sensitivity while still recording, because I'm not a professional YouTuber. Not yet. I could replay this flawlessly later, if need be. It's not going to be under controls, not under camera, game settings. So, confusing. It's not going to be key bindings. Maybe the mouse sensitivity is supposed to be really bad because it's part of the horror experience? Aim assist, image display, display screen, HUD, reticle. Okay, I'm gonna assume we're gonna just be this slow because Ethan Winters is this slow. I'm just used to fast games. Climb over with W. And Ethan is not gonna be fast for any reason. And he's gonna trip over everything. That was a rope, I think. And here we go.
Where the hell am I?
You're in Europe, Ethan. This is what Europe looks like, Ethan. I don't know how long he's been here, but he's never walked outside once and saw a castle. Until now. But there are castles everywhere in Europe, Ethan. There's the sunrise. So we actually have a direction, because the sunrise is in the east. So that's the east, that is the south, that is the west, that is the north. So that's a fun fact. You can see a windmill in the distance. You can see a factory in the distance, kind of faint. I assumed that there was going to be a waterfall for some reason, but I don't see it from here. But this gives me a good idea of where everything is. So I see the tops of what looks like maybe a church. We're not going to get a good view of it from down here, obviously. I tried my best to get a good look. That looks like Dolby, Louisiana beer. What's that doing here? Oh, whoa. That showed up for the first time. Maybe because that's the first time I've seen a pick-up-able item. This horse looks like its throat has been ripped out, and it has been frozen recently. I'm going to say it's probably recently. Somebody spilled a lot of eggs. Which door do I go into? You? Yes, I can just push on you.
Maybe, and then you maybe open. They're out?
Yeah, maybe they're just out, because, you know, potatoes grow back their vines overnight, obviously. Maybe they're not dead or something. Like, this doesn't look like they've been gone for too long. This is recent. Hello, you again. And somebody just took a huge bite out of the walls. So, yeah, Ethan, you're right. They're just leaving for 5 minutes. They'll be back anytime. And this is a different house, apparently. And these ones have animals. So that menu keeps popping up. Looks like cat carriers. Maybe it's for chickens, actually. And here's a bunch of stables. And a bunch of sounds that looks like one of the animals is home. Hello, where are the animals? I mean, your horse is dead, but where are your other animals? You clearly have chickens if you have eggs. This looks like an outhouse. And I'm not sure what you're putting in your outhouse. I guess all your trash? It seems like a problem. This needs some kind of other item. That is a well. This looks like an actual stable. Except, without the actual animal, the horse. Wait, do you guys handcuff your horses by their hoofs or something? Why is that there? That is a strange place to put handcuffs. Ethan, you turn so slowly, Ethan. And we have these stairs, so I'm pretty sure I didn't miss anything. Trying to be observant, trying to study the lore details. They're giving me away. Do not enter. I'll remember to not enter by this water tower. We are looking for Rose. But also looking for all the missing animals, I suppose. They look like they've all been eaten by something. And or, like Ethan said, they're just out. All the animals are just out on the streets. I really can't tell what's going to move me forward, what's not going to move me forward. So if I accidentally go move past an area and I can't revisit it, that would suck. I don't mean for that to happen. I know a lot about this game, but playing it for yourself is actually quite different. It means you only have a vague idea of where things are, but you don't actually know. So somebody's upstairs. They have a monkey too. What is this doing here? Indeed. Because I think that is Rose's exact same monkey. I don't think that these monkeys are popular toys. So that's gotta be Rose's. And Ethan, why didn't you take it with you? That seems important. Maybe we didn't want to take up inventory space. Whoa. That, I know what that is. That is the religious symbol of the Megamite seat on the wall. Now, that's foreknowledge. And there's that up there, also foreknowledge. So I'm glad to have found that, because I'm pretty sure nobody has really pointed these things out before. What is weird is the villagers do have repetitive pictures. So there's nothing else in there. And then here's a draft horse is supposed to pull this wagon. And my menu is constantly popping up. Believe me, I am not doing that. And we're going to walk this slow because Ethan has decided that. Oh, wait, I do have a little bit of a sprint button. Okay, it's also flowers, suitcases, the same beer. That almost looks like orange juice and potatoes. So that be a dead end. Now, we are still looking for people, and the castle is still in view. This village does look really interesting. I don't think we could see... No, yeah, there's the windmills. The factory is a lot more distant, though. But we still have a good vantage point of where everything is. Here's a tractor. It's still on. Here are the goat heads with their tongues out.
What happened?
Well, as you can see, Ethan, they beheaded a bunch of goats. Why, though? Probably to eat meat. It's cold as heck in the winter. Why else do you cut up goats except to probably eat them? This wagon's also been wrecked. I don't really know. I don't have a flashlight or anything. So if something is dark, I'm just kind of in the dark. Pots and pans. The first indication that somebody's home. A light. And they also have harriers for animals. There are the chickens. They've been locked up. The poor chickens need to be emancipated. And so we have the first house is not devastated by some unknown force. Okay, good. The light's going to adjust itself. There's some wood. Anything else? Any hidden secrets? Okay. I don't see anything. A yellow box. Some force could break it. I can't use my hands, though. I don't know how to do that. That looks like a knife. Next. I can attack with this knife. Alrighty, then we're going to touch this. And that. A first aid med. I probably should have read it, but I'm pretty sure not everything is lore. Not everything has a deep significant meaning. I say idiotically as I miss the deep significant meaning. So, a flashback to the baker house. Did suspicious they just food.
Run out of the house?
That looks recent as well. Look at it again, Ethan. It looks almost like the thingy your wife was making, except without vegetables, so it's just broth. And they put away those spoons and forks in the worst fashion possible. So people live on potatoes and orange juice and garlic out here. And this is the same dead plant. Right there. And then these are goat skulls and deer skulls. And that looks like a painting of the village. Let's see, around this table, here's a bed. So, with the light on, there's got to be one living person in here. Still in here. Probably back behind this curtain. Let's yank it open, Ethan. No, surprise! No,
friendly.
He totally did shoot me.
Who sent you? Nobody. There was an accident down on the road and... What's going on? Oh no. They're coming.
Yeah, you did shoot me, so that was a loud sound.
What the hell was that? Do you have a gun? What? Please tell me you have a gun. No, why would I?
I only have hands, bro.
Take it!
I don't know how to use my hands, sorry. Yeah, he totally shot me with that earlier. It's hard to listen when that's happening, Ethan.
What the?
Yeah, just stare at that and he's probably fine. We're about to be fine too. So where'd that hand go? A hand reached out through the floor, yanked us down, but there's nothing here except this thing, whatever this is.
Dead body?
Yeah, a dead body, Ethan, what is that?
There's more.
Wait, there's more. So, yeah, that guy's really close. We're backed up against a wall, so there's nowhere to go except to look at this dude. Can I examine? No, I guess I already did examine you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12? I'm probably counting too many. Nice to know I have bullets, though. How do I have to get right up in your face? Yes, let's look at your face. Are you the same guy twice? Yeah, it looks like you are.
Jesus Christ.
So, all of them have been, probably...
What the hell is wrong with this place?
Shot in the head is my thought. Except for you. That almost looks like Ethan. And you can see a creature right there. Just waiting. Are you gonna... There you go. A different one. All this is a cutscene, so I can't examine it. Hey, the wedding ring is still on, though.
What was that?
You You know what that is, Ethan. It's a person. It's a very feral person. So, why'd you pull out your knife? Alright. Apparently you really want to die, Ethan, by pulling out your knife. And he's slow, so good luck trying to dodge. And I'm trying to get all headshots. Missed at least one bullet. And there's a reload. Let's just do that really quick. Well, that was your fishing move, Ethan. Okay. Nah, it's it. My bad, wasted a bullet. Ammo's very rare in Resident Evil games, so this is quite bad. Alrighty, so that was a person, Ethan, a feral person. So let's go back where they were. And let's see. Can I backtrack at all? Bolt cutters. That's definitely going to be handy for all the things that are bolted up. So we can't backtrack. That's something I get worried about. Why am I switching between weapons like that? Why that's weird is because I'm only pressing WASD. The buttons you're supposed to press. And Ethan is just kind of going through these weapons by himself. I'm definitely not pressing anything. Interesting. Pick up chem fluid. Yeah, just keep switching like that for some reason. What are these? Apples, I think. Lots of apples. That is an herb. I don't know what kind of herb. It reminds me a little bit of seeing nettle, but that would hurt. Not be a healy thingy. So now we know there are monsters and we need to progress with bolt cutters. Or the family photo. We could use this on that. What do you mean I can't use a family photo on that? Bolt cutters. The slow reveal of whatever that is. A house? There's a stream running through here. And it's been barricaded by the same kind of devastation that barricades everything. And that looks suspicious. That looks like another one of those thingies that I don't want to reveal too soon because gotta play the game with continuity as if no one has seen this for the first time. Nothing. Alright. So, this is a stable with no animals in it. This is handgun ammo. I almost called it handgum ammo. Somebody went squish all over the walls. I can barricade doorways. Do that. Ethan? Oh, I guess I'm supposed to move? What do I need to press with shelves? This is weird. He just puts his hands on it and lets go. I would barricade. Is it that? Oh, I probably hold it. Oh, God. Apparently, if you just press a button, touches it and lets go. I know it said hold F. I'm just focusing on so many things at once that I was not holding F. And either that's really fragile or Ethan is really heavy. I can't tell. Let's see. Chem fluid. And let me take that ammo so that I can shoot you guys in the face. Well, Ethan. Oops. Oh, of course, yeah, fire it just because I switched to it instead of the knife that you keep pulling out for no reason. Stop pulling out that knife. Nobody asked. Let's see. I don't know if I'm getting hits. I'm so worried about that. It also sounds like they're coming out of... There you are. Yeah, we have only 14 or 24 bullets, Ethan. So that's not good. We can't kill all of them. In fact, we can probably only kill one of them, but we're not being directly threatened, so I guess we just wait. And if I die from waiting, then I don't know what I'm doing. One of them's in. The ducking that they're doing makes it quite difficult to aim. Nope. Let me reload. I'm pretty sure I barricaded myself in here with you. Oop. Trying to turn fast enough so I can actually shoot what's coming after me. I bet you drop bullets, actually, so please go down. I need your bullets. There we go. Russ's scrap is not what I imagined a bullet looks like. Is that it? I just kill one? Hello?
Over.
Interestingly, they're walking away after I kill one of them. Yes, hello?
Hello. If there are any survivors out there, come to my... to Louisa's house near the fields.
Survivors?
It's like he's never heard of survivors before. Let's see. Do I whack my way out of here? I don't think so. I guess I unbarricade the door. My hand looks so gored up. Huh. Okay, it does open. But the fact he's using his left wrecked hand. Let's see. This is actually not backtracking. Yeah, just ignore me, guys. Pay me no mind. Wait, I have to pick that up. There we go. Like, they're clearly looking at me. They see me. They're choosing to not attack. Until I found this thing, an M1897, which I guess is a shotgun. They wanted me to grab that really quick before anything. What is this? Gunpowder. And this is flour. Nice to know. So they sounded very angry, like they were rushing to get me, but where are they? They're making a lot of roaring sounds. Rust is scrap. Shift to run. Which I've already been using that a little bit. That's the flower thing again. I guess it's suggesting that I make that an escape. Oh, control is heal. Oops, I was pressing that to duck because of a different game. But C is to crouch, so that's important to know. So I'm gonna have to run around a little bit. Because we do that. Ooh, shotgun ammo. We run around until... I think I picked up an herb. Where is the ladder?
There's no end to them.
There's no end to them. We run around until, like, a cutscene or something. There we go. I think they're also throwing arrows, so they have mastered weaponry. Nope. Also nope. I was trying to run by you, but you did that. I don't think I want to waste ammo. I'm running around. Until something happens, I guess. So we've already been in here. This is a loop. Did I miss anything? Don't think so. There's one of those down there. So, C. It's C. Get out of my way. And this is a different house, I think. What's in here? No, maybe I... Ah, this is either the same house or a similar house. Open that. Got whatever that was. I'm trying to switch weapons, as you can see right now. I'm reloading, are you kidding me? Is it really a one-shotter? Thanks. Let's get out to the river. Important things are probably gonna happen. That's locked. Alright, so I'm mostly trying to ignore you guys unless you're actually on top of me killing me. We're gonna follow this river. Oh, hey! Whatever you are. Hopefully I'm not dead. Reload. Reload. Oh, I'm dying. So I'm just trying to run now. Because there's nowhere else to go, nothing else to do. And suddenly I'm healed. I really don't want to waste this. But if you insist. I'm out of ammo. Picking that up. Hello. Am I going the wrong place? How do I switch weapons to something that works? Ow. Am I actually dying? So, I'll start from my most recently saved data. He's screaming at my face. But that's weird, because I know there's supposed to be a cutscene. So it's like, I am and am not supposed to die at the same time. Let's see. Did this already happen? I don't think so. No, wait, yes it did.
Over?
It's over. So, I'm also trying to keep this under 30 minutes. But I wanted to at least get to the point of moving on.
If there are any survivors out there, come to Louisa's house near the field.
We're going to Louisa's house, yes, but where is that? That is not that intuitive. And those guys are still up there watching me, but not attacking for some reason. Not yet. I have to go to a certain point to get attacked. There it is. Let's grab that. And gunpowder. That's flour. Now I gotta remember not to accidentally use the healing by pressing control instead of C. Alrighty. So you guys are and aren't attacking me yet. Hello? Hello? There we go. We are running around until something happens. I guess this is when they start actually attacking me. Here's the herb. I guess I could have pressed F. I need to press F to pick up every piece of ammo, too. So, I'm learning as I'm playing, as you can see. I did not switch between these weapons. I'm pressing WASD. There we go. Ammo. Now, I'm pretty sure this is more of a backtracking way.
There's no end to them.
There's no end to them. And we've been here. Oh, but this is open now. Sorry. You guys are too close. A water wheel. A gate.
Shit!
Yeah, it's a dead end. So let's hit that. Ooh, I need that. Money. Can I enter that? Can I enter that? No. The wheel is on fire. Ooh, I can pick that up. Oh, it's out of ammo. That's what's up. I was like, why am I just staring at this dude? Do you want me to waste all my ammo or something? Clearly you guys don't go down easy. I wanted to pick that up, whatever that is. Lay, okay. Let's go. No, don't pick up the gun that doesn't work. All right, we've been here. Stop picking up the gun that doesn't work, Ethan. That makes no sense. Lock from the other side. So what do we do when we run out of ammo, I wonder? Ow. Go down, please. Try to land every bullet. I'm out. Cool. Crystal skull. Oh, control. 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 There we go. I don't think I go up here. I'm pretty sure I've been up here. Ooh, gunpowder. I really don't know what would help me progress. Maybe it is running down as far as I can down this river. Ooh. examine. Locked. There's some candles here for some reason. Hello. How do I get by you guys? My gun has no bullets. Can you help me, please? That's not helping. Ooh, gunpowder. So, someone's bound to help me eventually, right? That's locked. I'm pretty sure I've thoroughly explored this map and there's nowhere to go. There we go. That's new. That's different. Just throw me in the river! Where did I go? It almost looks like he threw me at a wall and I teleported into the river. The horsies are mine! They're like really talkative, really trying to scream in my face. And I met you. Look at that beard. And that hair and everything. So, his voice is very impressive, hearing it through the headphones. There's a bassy rumble to it. And there they go! Being called by something. As the house sets on fire in the background. Because they had to use flaming arrows in their own village. Burning down their own houses. And there had to be an arrow mighty, and my hand is completely wrecked. Or specifically, Ethan's hand. I'm just pretending to be Ethan right now. I don't know where he got that gauze from, but thank goodness we had that. Gasp! An old lady.
Wait.
She opened the way for us, and then closed the way on us. Alright. We gotta pause here. We got the not liking this achievement. Pause it here for the sake of YouTube.